Alright, let's take a look up here before we talk to what's her name. Ugh.
I get strange comms chatter every time I fly by Mars.
Oh, yeah? Rest and go guest terminal. Pay to view movies. Pay to view is restricted to diamond level guests, but feel free to peruse our catalog. Entertainment cartridges are available for rent at the main desk. There are currently zero cartridges in stock. My big canid friend. Synopsis. A lab-grown giant canid goes on an adorable rampage, leading a family of scientists on a wild chase across Emerald Vale. Spending the holiday away from home proves to be a chore, but the family soon realizes the true friends are the monsters you meet along the way. Rated FSR 11 for fun time simulated rampage and body count 11. Nanner Spank 7, Primal Affections. Raised by a wilderness primals, one man will leave the jungle he knows to explore the one he doesn't. Keystone. He came for Nanner Spank, but he stayed for love. Can a young corporate executive collar this creature, or will she awaken the beast within? Rated PACNS for passion, anthropoid, and consensual Nanner Spanking. Okay. Pay-to-view serials. Again, zero cartridges in stock. Baking with Edna. In this time-honored culinary classic, Chef Edna gives valuable life lessons while she cooks from the Book of Approved Cakes. Learn to maintain a structured kitchen, obey your head chef, achieve a good sponge, and obey your sous chef. Edna is the boss in her kitchen. Now she can be the boss of yours. Serial, Space Hospital. If the walls of Orbital Hospital could talk, they'd shriek with terror. These doctors have seen it all. Zero-G cyst lancing. Extraterrestrial teratoma. Next, on a very special episode, in order to trap a chem thief, Dr. Margrave must become a serial arsonist. Don't forget to see Space Hospital Nights for steamy suspense. Broderick's Brood? An ordinary colony family of daydreams of the extraordinary. While Lucia works in the factory canning processed borscht, her ham-handed husband cooks up schemes to land her a big promotion. Will that lovable fool ever learn to be satisfied with what he has? Broderick's Brood is a testament to the less-is-success family lifestyle. Access guest messages. Okay. I'm reading this guy's messages, and he's right behind me. From Veritas, subject, be careful. To Iceman. One of UB's squealers came asking after you. Wanted to know what you like to drink, who you talk to, what your temperament's like. Tried to pay me off. I took the bits and told her a pack of lies. Watch your back when you get in. Don't want to find you in the waste disposal chute. Space for the SEC. Icy. Been a while since I heard from you. You're on that long haul out of Dashkova right now. Hope it goes well. I got a space for you and yours to meet when you get back. Just a storage room, but it's quiet and safer than the bar. Should be able to accommodate most of you folks. No fees or nothing. Just let me buy you a beer. V. From Rizzo, PR. Oh, public relations for Rizzo products. Subject, please stop. To McRed. Oh, that's the guy we're looking for. G. McRed. Mr. McRed, we have reviewed your proposal for the 10th time and still do not agree that galactic mushroom is an acceptable flavor for a Rizzo beverage. Even if we were to pursue the idea, the samples you sent us were dangerously hallucinogenic. The unopened package alone caused mayhem in our receiving bay. Please don't reach out to us again. well, you're not McCready or whatever. McCred? McCready is the guy from the thing. I suppose he might spot me if I take this stuff. Okay, just pick these up. Not stealing, apparently. of goodies I just got rid of, now I'm picking up again. That's it. Oh wait, no, I got a few more things. Okay. So she's in here, apparently. Greetings.
Bless my heart. A stranger come knocking on a poor old woman's door. You here for a particular reason? Or did the neighbors tell you how good my sugar cookies are?
Oh?
Made without a single natural ingredient or an oven, just like store-bought.
Not sugar cookies. Phineas sent me. He said you could sell me a nav key to Stellar Bay.
Those have been the height of illegality since Stellar Bay turned their noses up at the board. You and I could be thrown to the void just for discussing such a transaction.
Oh, that's no good.
Lucky for us, Groundbreaker's a free port. We're outside of the board's control. For the time being, at least. Now, I only have the one nav key. And they're hard to come by these days. It won't be cheap. If you find yourself lacking in the bits, I might have an opportunity you'd be interested in.
Since for some reason I know it's 10,000 bits, all of a sudden, yes, I am lacking in the bits. Any chance of a discount since Phineas sent me a rather heavy discount?
Phineas, that old kook. He was quite the dancer back in his prime, did he tell you?
No.
Real light on his feet. Real light in the wallet, too. He still owes me a small fortune. Laws, maybe I should charge you double.
Better yet, tell me about this opportunity.
Well, I find I'm in need of a ship captain with a little moral flexibility. Might be this could help out the Groundbreaker, as well as earn some bits. But if you've got qualms...
No qualms here, at least so far. Let's hear the details.
Do you know Edna, over in engineering? Sweet as a pea, that
one. Not yet, no.
On occasion, she'll pass along transmissions I might find interesting. She sent me a recording of a distress signal she'd scraped from the Groundbreaker's comm array.
Oh.
Curious thing is, it came from an outpost called Roseway. And Auntie Cleo abandoned that place years ago.
I do have to go to Roseway. Why was Roseway abandoned?
Can't say I know for sure. Maybe it never really was.
No.
Sounds like someone poking into somewhere they shouldn't be got into a spot of trouble.
Comm centers don't operate themselves, Captain. Someone had to have sent that distress call manually.
Right.
Those corps are cleverer than all get out. Might have been a ruse to keep the rest of the board from sniffing around.
You guys sure it couldn't be some kind of automated message?
Edna didn't seem to think so. And I trust the dear girl's judgment. Well, maybe not in men, but she knows her comms. So, like as not, someone's been down there recently. And if someone set up shop in Roseway, I'd wager they got something to hide.
If it's a corporate town with something to hide, but then why the SOS?
Maybe whatever they're hiding went to heck. And now they need a few spare hands to clean up the mess. If you should find a secret worth selling, might be I could find a buyer. Corporate bigwigs will pay top bit for inside information on their competitors. The more we got the corps fighting each other, the less time they got to meddle in our affairs.
So you need someone to snoop around for you.
My goodness, aren't you quick on the uptake? I like that. Should you find yourself responding to a certain distress call, and in so doing find yourself in possession of certain valuable corporate secrets, well...
Nudge, nudge, wink,
wink.
Then we
ought to have a chat over a pot of tea and my famous cookies.
I'll stop by if I find anything.
Law bless your Adams. Here's a copy of the SOS recording, complete with the coordinates. Don't forget to come find old Gladys when you're done.
What other jobs do you know about?
Might want to acquaint yourself with Junlei Tennyson, Groundbreaker's chief. She's been trying to get a handle on this heat problem we've got.
I am.
You'll find her fretting in engineering. I'd say she's a sweet girl, but law for fen someone call me a liar.
Want to ask you something else?
What do you want, then? My hard-earned wisdom?
What do you do here?
Oh, a little of this, a little of that. I buy and sell items that require discretion to dispose of. Knickknacks. Curios. I also knit throw pillows stuffed with the hair of famous tossball players.
Huh?
But that's more of a passion project.
I'm not sure that's entirely legal.
Yeah.
That's half the reason I make them, my dear. But that's not what you wanted to talk about, is it, dear?
Not exactly. Why did the board recall the Stellar Bay nav keys? Let me guess. Big monsters?
Ask the common folk, and they'll tell you it's on account of all the monsters on Monarch desperate to gobble you up. Because that's what the board tells them, you see. I think they made some fool mistake that would make them look bad to the rest of the colony, and they're trying to hide the evidence.
What makes you think that?
Those board folk are real prideful-like. Never want you looking behind the curtain, lest you see their derrieres. But old Gladys knows the score. The whole colony's not much more than a diorama, showcasing one board screw-up after another. That's why we gotta keep them from getting their grubby mitts on Groundbreaker. She's our mess.
Are there still people down there?
Probably. Every once in a while, we get these snippets of radio chatter. Edna shows them to me. Some man hooting and hollering about the light in us all. Claims he's transmitting from Monarch. But who knows if that's true. Might be true. Might be some new trick from the board.
You mentioned Groundbreakers outside of the board board's control.
That's right, dearie. The only independent station in the colony. That's us. Though for how long, I can't say. That all depends on Miss Junlei.
How do you mean?
The board can't abide a community that won't bend to its will. They've always got one scheme or another running, looking for ways to bring us to heel. Like this heat business. Shameful. But it won't work. No, ma'am. Groundbreaker's free till the day she dies, law willing.
Okay.
Go right ahead, sweetheart.
So what is this about the heat?
Groundbreaker's radiators. Been neither fine nor dandy for weeks now. Miss Junlei's supposed to be getting them fixed, but the board's determined to get in her way.
How do you mean? Let me guess, they're trying to exert their control?
The board can't abide a community.
Yeah.
They've always got one.
Yeah.
But it won't work.
Thanks.
No. Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me. Here, take a candy with you.
Oh, thanks. Whoa. I leveled up. So what is this that we have? Distress call. This data log contains a recording of an automated distress call. Your ship's computer can display the call and retrieve the source coordinates. Obtained from Gladys on the Groundbreaker, this recording originates from Roseway, a town thought long abandoned by Auntie Cleo. Where do I want to put, well, actually, I just want to look at this for a second. General quests. The cleaning machine. Supposed to go, to Roseway. So that's where that goes. Skills. I want to get more. Better at this kind of stuff. And leadership is good, too. So I have, you can order companions to do special attacks. They get up to 40. They get 20% plus 20% armor rating. Yeah, I am letting melee just die. Someone else can do melee. I do want to get defense at some point. Let's get some medical. Okay. A second drug mixing slot to the inhaler. Increases duration of effects, opens extra slots. Alright. It's bound to be handy. Well, tech improves medical science and engineering. Here we go. Sweet. We got better at some stuff. Hi.
Watch where you're looking, buddy.
I am?
Hmm?
Hmm. Alright, so Tennyson is 120 meters is that way. Oh, he's sleeping now. Can I just take the stuff now that he's asleep?
Understood. I will keep my head down.
Knock you out, bar. Yes, I am robbing him blind. It's his fault for just falling asleep like that and leaving his door unlocked. I know I would have picked the lock anyway. Sleep well.
You couldn't pay me to visit Monarch. I'd probably get my face eaten off.
Yeah, it makes me wonder if there are monsters up there.
With I'm not going anywhere, you hear?
Ellie?
You can't get me out of there.
Please don't make a scene, Dr. Fenhill.
I am not making a scene.
Define scene. Hi.
I'm sorry. Am I causing a scene?
You said you weren't.
See, Umfuru? We could have avoided all this unpleasantness if you just let me talk to Jessie in the first place.
What's this about your friend?
Let me get one thing straight. Jessie and I are not friends. I just owe her, okay?
Okay.
As for the rest, I'm trying to figure that out. All I know is that she's been here too long, and she's apparently not receiving visitors.
So, wait, you don't even like her, but you're checking on her?
You say that like it's weird.
But why bother?
Like I said, Jessie did me a favor, and now I owe her one. I just don't like to leave a debt unpaid, that's all.
Maybe I can look in on Jessie.
Be my guest. If you know something I don't about dealing with hospital bureaucracy, I'll be impressed.
Hmm. In the meantime, I guess you'll be over there.
Something I can help you with?
Hmm. Well, first, can I buy supplies from you? You seem well stocked.
Not without dispensation from Chief Junlei, I fear. Supplies are hard to come by out here.
What do you mean?
We don't have the ability to manufacture our own medical supplies here on Groundbreaker. Regrettably, we are dependent on the board for such mundane items as bandages and antibiotics, as well as more critical resources like adequately trained staff.
Oh.
We'd nearly signed a supply agreement with Anti-Cleos, but they demanded we only use their branded drugs, and that's simply not tenable.
Man, these corporations really do stink in the future, don't they? I'd like to see Jessie Doyle.
If only my other patients had so many inquiring after them. I'll tell you what I've told the others.
Oh boy.
The records say Ms. Doyle checked herself in and requested I admit no visitors. The requests of our patients are paramount, so no, you may not see her.
The records say... Have you actually spoken to her yourself?
She's not my patient. I'm certain no one on my staff would falsify patient records, if that's what you're implying.
Okay.
Take care.
Do you mind? Messages. To Captain Irion, subject, where are my automax? Well, that's not about Jessie, but, I need a status update, Irion. From W. Dorset to Captain Irion. I know you boasted about the Scylla shortcut, but could you maybe venture through a pocket of space that isn't infested with pirates? You know, pirates. The ones who love cargo and hate rules. Here in MedBay, we've got blunt tools, watered-down meds, long shifts, and shaky hands. Don't let me down. Logs? Staff shortage. Groundbreaker MedBay Terminal. I'm at my wit's end coordinating with any authority outside of Groundbreaker. The board won't dispatch a surgeon unless Junlei agrees to share a third of all docking revenue, and Spacer's Choice won't send supplies unless we make an executive deal to use their products. No thank you. I've seen enough shoddy needles breaking off in patients' arms. I need a chat with Junlei about this, but she has problems of her own. Some of us are growing concerned about the cost of Groundbreaker's independence. So I wonder if there's another way in here? Can I just go in? Hello?
Dr. Dorset's a deft hand with a blade. Hardly leaves a scar.
Can't say I've seen you before. I take it you're a freighter, Captain? If you're here to better yourself, you'll have to wait. We're having a spot of trouble with our delivery service.
Better myself? Isn't this the med bay?
Sure is. You need a deft hand to straighten a busted nose or sparkle up those not-so-pearly whites? I'm your gal. Of course, there's not much cosmetic improvement going on at the moment. Not without my mechanicals. Where the law is Irion anyway?
You do cosmetic surgery on this rickety space station?
Sure. How do you think we keep this pile of junk in the sky? It costs bits, and a little prettying up brings in a fair few of them. Or it would, if I had my dang mechanicals.
What's going on?
I'm expecting our delivery fellow to stop through with medical supplies and service auto mechanicals. Name's Captain Irion. A brave idiot with a penchant for getting himself delayed. Sometimes by dates, usually by bandits.
What do you need the mechanicals for?
Surgery, mostly. Medical personnel are difficult to come by on Groundbreaker.
Why is that?
The board won't let their doctors and nurses station here, and they own all the medical schools.
Oh.
If we can't hire their people, we can't hire anyone. Everyone on staff here on Groundbreaker was trained by me or Idris. We're good, don't get me wrong. But we've only two heads between us, and we don't know everything.
I could try to find this Captain... Irion?
I'd be grateful if you'd spare the time. We need his delivery soon as yesterday. Last he told me, He was taking a shortcut by Scylla, an asteroid in the Charybdis cluster. That's where I'd start, were I the adventuring type. You look out, though. The place is probably crawling with outlaws.
Yeah, it's gonna be a protracted amount of time before I do that.
Keep hanging around, and I'll begin to think you're here for me. What can I do for you?
Nothing for now.
You have yourself a day, then.
Not a good day, just a day. Patient's medical chart. Patient experiences unusual side effects post-hibernation after his latest voyage. I guess this isn't Jessie? Complains of longer days and increased boredom, as if time itself is slowing down. I've never seen complications this severe in prescribing a high dosage of stims. While I'm optimistic that I can address the symptoms, the cause still troubles me. I'm going to try reaching out to conveyor crews and some corp docs I know on Terra 2 for answers. Update. I've learned that interstellar crews called this condition skip flu, and everyone I asked said they know someone who knows someone who had it. In extreme cases, they say the person's body and mind break down entirely. Board medics, the few who bothered to reply, insisted the patient was making it up to shirk their duties. I don't believe my patient is malingering, but how do I prove that when the board won't even review my evidence? This board really is a problem, aren't they? Oof.
Does Dr. Mfuru ever take a day off?
We should probably ask him. sorry to bother you.
Still haven't found a good way to get the blood out from under my nails.
Better you than me. Quarantine operating room. Hi. Can I try to use my holographic shroud to get back and talk to Jessie?
Slow day, huh?
Quarantine.
You ever wonder if maybe folks keep doors closed for a reason?
Yeah, so people like us can... enterprising individuals can find their way inside. I can't open that. Ellie sent me?
What? Why? Everything's fine. We're all fine here. No need for her to be worrying her pretty little head about me. I'm just terrible, dreadful sick is all. Got a cough that won't quit and sores all over my body. Highly, lethally contagious. But I'll be fine, so long as I'm left alone.
I don't know if I want what she's got, but open the door before I kick it down.
Damned if I don't rue the day I saved her scrawny little hide. Inadvertently, I befriended a bloodhound in the process. All right, okay. We can discuss this like the level-headed folk that we are. Seems I've got to do something before Ellie goes jabbering my business to anyone with one ear and an intent to listen.